Hey guys, DK here, and welcome to another one of my tutorials. Today we're gonna make the piranha plant. Here he is. I got a special request from Corina Hojila. Hopefully I pronounced that correctly. Sorry if I didn't. But she asked me to do this one again because I had it on my profile pic. And so I said yes, and this is what we end up with after he's all done. Kind of what he looks like. Alright, so let's get started. Alright, so first off, what you want to do is take your green, and we're going to make 25 pairs facing forward like this. Just slip one in like that, and make 25 pairs of these. And then after you get those pairs made up, then just start connecting them all together. Okay, like that. And then what we're gonna do is take them and we're gonna bend it around backwards, like that. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna just, these are all gonna be backwards from now on. You're just gonna slide it on there just like that, and you're gonna make 8 more rows. You're gonna have 10 rows total facing backwards. Just keep going around and make 8 more rows. Okay, this is what you should be looking like after you have your 10 rows done, all facing like this. Now what we're gonna do is flip it over, so this is gonna be the bottom, and then we're gonna take the green again, but this time we're going to be putting them in forwards instead of backwards. So just go like that and put them in like that going forward. And what we're going to do is we're going to do 5 more rows of the green, but this time they're all going forward, and you're just going to build up from here. Okay, all right that's what you should be looking like after you get those 5 rows on there. So altogether you should have 10 rows that are facing backwards and then 5 rows that are facing forward. So 15 total, and that'll make the tube for the piranha plant. Now I'll show you how to make the stem. It's pretty easy. All you're gonna do is just take 2 green and put one in the middle. And then put 2 more on the top, and then one in the middle, and then just keep doing that until you have 20 of the double rows. So you have 1, 2, and then keep counting all the way up until you have 20 of them. But I have to get 20 of them on there. You want to make sure you don't glue it yet or anything, because what you're going to want to do is it's going to go in there and kind of bend this way, and then it's going to bend back around. So you're going to be kind of about, actually go the other way. This way. And then it's going to bend around like that and sit in there like that. So you'll have it sitting in there like that. So you'll want to get it to where, and remember it's got to support the head also, so these will have to eventually be glued, but you'll want to get them kind of an S shape. So it sits there and the back of it kind of braces against the side. But for right now, we'll just put that off to the side. And that's the stem and the tube. And next I'll show you how to make his head. Okay, before I do his head real quick, we'll make his tongue. And all you're gonna do is take your pink or light pink, whichever color will work either way. And you're gonna start off making a row of three on the bottom. And the second row is gonna have four. And then we're gonna go up to five. Then I go back down to four. And then back up to five. And then down to four. And then to three. And that'll be his tongue. And next I'll show you how to make his head. Alright, to start off making his head, what we're going to do is take the white pieces and you're just going to take two of them, both of them facing forward, and we're going to make 11 pairs of the white, just like that. So make 11 of these. Then after you get that done, just connect them all together. Like that. And now we're going to put one more row of white on there. There we go. Now what we're going to do is take the red and we're going to put a row of red on there. And now put one more row of red on. Okay, and now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this and we're gonna increase it from 11 up to 22. The way we're gonna do that is you just take a red, put it in between, and then just add one red on each side. And then you're going to keep doing that all the way around. And it doesn't really matter where, but you're going to want to put one white in there. That'll be our starting point for the next rows. You just put one white, and the rest, you just put one in the middle of the red, and then fill the rest with red all the way around. Okay, now you'll have 22 all the way around. Now what we're gonna do is, starting off with this white right here, we're gonna put two above it, one on each side, and then you're gonna count over seven, so you go 1, 2, 3, 4. And on the seventh one, put one white, another one right next to it, and then count over 5 more. And then on the sixth one, put 2 white. So it'll look like that. And then fill the rest in with red. All right, so go back to this one that has a one below it. That has a 3. And we're gonna put one white right in between there, like that. And then this one's going to have 3 white, so starting on the other one over, add 3 white on there. And then same with this one, add 3 white. And then fill the rest in with red. There we go. Now starting, look here, go to the right. Starting with this one, we're gonna add 4 white here, right here. And then same with this one also, add 4 white. Okay, and then fill the rest in with red. There we go. Now starting with this side, we're gonna go from 4 down to 3. And then same with this one, we'll go down to 3 also. Okay, same thing. After you get those on, fill the rest in with red. Now what you're gonna do is, you look over, go to the right, this one right here. This one's gonna go down to 2. Then so is the other one. And then what you're gonna do is, from this one, that's to the right of the 4, you're gonna count over, was it 3 spots, so you're gonna go 1, 2, and on the third, put a white and one next to it, like that. And then fill the rest of these in with red. Do is take your white, take the 2 that you just put in there by themselves, and put 1 white on each side, like that, and then skip over to this one, skip over that one to this one, and we'll put one white on each side. Like that. And then fill it in with red. Sorry, forgot to mention, don't put red right here or here. Leave these spots open. Don't put anything here or here. Now what we're gonna do is go up again and put a white on each side like that, and go to the other side and the same thing. Put a white on each one and then fill in these two sides with red. And then one other thing, after you get, let's see, right on this one, you're gonna want to go over 3 and then we're gonna take one white and put it in there and then continue with the rest with red. Like that. And then same thing, just add another white to each side. And then what you're going to do right here, we are going to go and add 2 white right on top of it. Like that. And then fill the rest of these in with red. So what should be looking like right about now? So now what we're going to do is take white and we're going to go one in on each of these. Just put one in like that on all of them. And then fill the rest of these two sides in with white. Okay, and we'll get you that done. You're just gonna do one more row, just starting in on each one. Just go in one. And then fill those in with white. And there you go. And there's his head. And then you can kind of push around on some of them, make it a little more round. It'll look like that. So this will be the top. And what you're going to want to do is take his tongue that you made, and it's just going to go in the back. And you just position it the best you can. You're just going to pretty much set it down in there and then glue it down so it'll look like that. And then after you get this tongue glued in, you're going to give him some fangs. And I just took some of the white and just smashed them down, put a little glue in there and smashed them flat. They'll still open up, but the pockets are glued down. What you're going to want to do is start with the third one. You're going to count. Just go 1, 2, and then 3. Put one in there. And then just 1, 2, 3 on this side. You just kind of slip them over Well, it's kind of hard to see, but you just slip them over part right there. Same on the other side. Just go 1, 2, count in 3. Put it in there. And the same 1, 2, 3. Like that. And then what we're gonna do is, so we're gonna count in 8 or 4. Let's see. Put it in there and then count in 4 from that side. Go like that. And same with the bottom, just 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can glue these in there to have them stay a little bit better. That'll be kind of his fangs. You want to make sure you get this, his tongue, glued in first, because it'll be a pain in the butt trying to get it through his teeth. He'll just have his there and then have his teeth on there. So make sure you get his tongue glued in first. And that's pretty much what you're gonna do with his head. After you get this bent and glued the way that you want to, that's why you wanna have these parts done first, because you'll kind of measure it on how he's gonna sit on there. Because he'll sit kind of like that. So that's his head and tongue. And if that's all you wanna build is just the pipe, the stem and the head, that's pretty much it. Next I'll show you how to make his leaves and then put some of the extras around him if you want to. Okay, next to make the leaves for him, that's what they'll look like when they're done. What you're gonna wanna do is take the light green and smash them flat as you can. And then you're gonna take the first one and slip it inside the bottom one. So it'll look like that. And then you're gonna take your next one and you're gonna put the back end in the pocket and also the front. So it fits, both of them fit in the pocket. And then you kind of push it down. It'll look like that. And then you just repeat that. The next one will slip down in between, so you have it like that, and then the one after will go into the pocket, and then you just slip it down. Like that. And that'll be one half. And then what you'll do is you'll take both of these and they'll be glued together. And that'll be your leaf. And you'll wanna glue these together. They'll keep falling apart if you don't. So just glue it together and then smash it as flat as you can. You can make them all and then place them between a couple books and smash them really flat. And that's how you make leaves. Next, I will show you the optional stuff that you can put around the pipe and the piranha plant. All right, so now I'm gonna show you how to build the little creatures that go around the piranha plant. It's all optional. If you don't wanna do it, you don't have to. But if you do, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off making the turtle. Then you're going to start off with a row of light green, 3 of them. 4 right above that. Then we go down to 3. And then we go back up to 4. And then what we do is take and put one green in the middle. And then one on each side. And then you're going to take a white, put it on one side, and another white, put it on the other side. Is take the couple more whites, put them on the middle like this. And then this last white is going to go over one, and it's going to have two in the end pocket. So it'll go on like that. Same with this other side. They'll just have two in one pocket and one in the other. Like that. And then you're going to take two yellow. Put one right here. The other right here. Like that. And then you're going to take two more yellow pieces. Kind of squish them together. And then you just slide them up into the other one. So it looks like that. And then what you'll do is you'll just take a piece of white and then color in a little black for his eye. And then all he's gonna do is you just kind of put it right in there in this edge right here. And glue it down, and he'll look like that, and that'll be your turtle. Okay, to make the little mushroom, little one-up mushroom, you're gonna start off with, you're gonna make a row of three black, and then a row of two, and then another row of three. And then we're gonna take the white, we're going to make a row of four. The next row is going to be five. So we'll put one white at the end. And then take a green. And then fill the rest of the row in with white. And then we're going to go in we're going to take and put two green on the top and then two white. Like that so far. And then take one more green, put it over the top, and take a white. Slide it right over there, like that. Take one more white, then a green, and another white. So it'll be like this. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna go from five, we're gonna go down to four. And then what you can do is put a little drop of glue in there, and you can put like a little rubber band, and it'll pinch them together to make it look more like a mushroom. Like that. And there's the mushroom for you. And next, I will show you how to make the flowers. Okay, to make the flowers, what you're gonna do is take your light green, and just take three of them and just stack them on top of each other like that. And then take two more and then put one on each side. Like so, and then stack three more. And that'll be the stem for the flower. To actually make the flower is quite fun. What you're gonna do is start with a white, and then take your yellow. One side's gonna go in here like this, and the other side's gonna go in like that. Same with this side. And then you take another yellow and put it right in between the two. So it'll be like that. Same with this other side. And they'll be together like that. And what you're gonna do, you kind of just push these in together. And you're gonna have to use a little bit of glue to get them to stay. And you try to fit them in the pocket, if you can see the front, or I guess the back. You try to get them to fit down in that little pocket right in here. Gluing these down anyways. But to get them started off, kind of get it like this. So you got a flat front. And then you're going to take your red. One red's going to go straight on the end of the yellow. And then you're going to take another red. And it's going to go on this side pocket right here. Same with the other side pocket right there. And then the other red is going to go in this pocket and then slip it down in between in the yellow. It's kind of hard to get it down there, but it will. And the same with the other side. Put this one in there and it slips right down in there. And that'll hold it right there. And then, you can actually take these apart if you want to. And then, you take your another red, and it goes, you're gonna put it on the outside pocket, just like that. Same with this other side. And that's pretty much one side of it. Now you have to make the other side. And you're just going to do it the same way that you did this side. And there's your two halves. And then what you're going to do is you got to kind of... Oops, forgot to put the other sides on. Pocket goes in there. And you're going to put them on the outer pocket. So holds them like that. And then these, you kind of just fold together. And then what you're gonna do is put a little glue on there and on the back. And then you can just either set something heavy or have something where you can just pinch them together, and that's how you're gonna glue them together so they'll hold and stay. And then you'll have the stem that goes right on it. Blue flower is exactly the same, except you use blue. Okay, so this is what I have done so far. After you get the pipe done and its stem and the head, I glued the stem to the back of his head. What I did was, to make it pretty stable, you have to glue every single one of these connections here and get it in just the right curve that you want it in. But after you glue it and set it on there, he's on there pretty good. On the back of here, on these green parts, I had some like shish kebab skewers, the wood sticks. I just cut off just like maybe an inch and jammed four of them, two on each of the green pieces, and glued them in. And then I was able to put some glue on the back of his head and then just slide this right in. And it held it up pretty nicely. So he's not going anywhere. These are what the leaves will look like when you get them done. Just also have a toothpick in the middle, and then just put glue and glue them both together. And so that'll be both the leaves. And you want to put some holes. You kind of want to measure them, set them in there, and see exactly. You can put the leaves wherever you want to. I just put them right above where he's resting on the pipe at. And the holes are a pain in the butt to make, so I kind of cheated and I had a little tiny drill, and I just drilled some holes right into the paper. But all you're gonna do is, after you do that, these will just slide right in there. Same with the other side, like that. And then when you set them down there, they'll have the leaves on there. And then all you're gonna do is put some glue on the front here and put some glue right on the back here where he rests, and that'll glue him on there, and then he'll stay on there. And if that's all you wanted to do, he's done, pretty much. If that's all you wanted is the pipe and the piranha plant. So for the extras, I made the mushroom, the turtle. I just cut out a little round piece and then colored a little black in there for his eye. And then made the flowers also. And you can just glue these to the side. And then also with the flowers, with the stem, all you're gonna do is just, if you're not gonna have a bottom piece, just kind of line it up to where it's gonna actually sit on the bottom. And then the flower will go right over the top of it. And then you'll glue the flower down. Just like that. And you can glue them however you want to, all the way around. But I'm gonna make a base for him to set on. And if you don't want to, that's fine. You could just glue these pieces around and make him just like that, and it'll look just as good. I just like a base for him. So I'll make the base and I'll show you guys how I did that. All right, so here he is, all finished. That's what he looks like at the end, after I got the mushroom and the flowers and the turtle glued on, and stem and pipe and stuff. And I decided to, for the base, I just took some thick cardboard and made a octagon shape out of it. And then I just took some colored paper and drew in the brick so it looks like it's all covered in bricks. You don't have to do that. It was kind of a pain in the ass to do anyways. But that's what it looks like, all completed. If you want to, I have another one that did a while ago, but this is just a square. All I used is cardboard also. Just cut out a square, and then for the edges, and then just glued them all together, same thing. Just drew out some lines to make it look like there's bricks on there. And that's all I did with that one, which was a lot easier than doing the octagon shaped one. And so that's pretty much it. If you guys like it, hit that like button. If you have any questions, leave a comment and subscribe, and I'll keep making them. Thanks.